Hello friends, next topic in DBMS is SQL functions. Okay, there are mainly two types of SQL functions. One is aggregate function, second one is scalar functions. In scalar function, again there are three types: numeric functions, string functions, and date and time function. Aggregate functions operate on many records. It operates on many records, not on one record. It operates on many records and produces summary. It produces what? Summary. Works with group by clause. It works with what? Group by clause. Whereas non-aggregate function operate on each record independently. Whereas the scalar function or non-aggregate function operate on each record independently. So first we study aggregate function. These functions returns a single value. It returns what? Single value. After performing calculations on a group of values. After performing calculation on many values, group of values. It returns one value. Following are some of the frequently used aggregate functions. First one is AVG function, count function, max function, min function, and last one is sum function. These are mostly used functions, mostly used aggregate functions. First one, AVG function. Average returns, AVG means average. AVG function returns average value after calculating it from values in a numeric column. Okay, it returns what? Average value. Okay, average means what? Total divided by total number, how many quantities are there. The syntax is select AVG of column name from table name. Syntax is what? Select AVG of column name from table name. Okay, sometimes you give condition also. Where condition? Consider the following EMP table. This is EMP table. There are 5 employees out there. Okay, suppose if you want to find the average of salary. Okay, means what? You have to find plus first total, then divide by how many records are there? 5 records are there, divided by 5. So for example, SQL query to find average salary will be, okay, how we write? Select AVG of salary, okay, average of salary from EMP table, this is EMP table. Okay, what is the average of salary? Okay, first you have to find total. Here 9000 plus 8000, 17000, 17000 plus 6000, 23,000 plus 10,000, 33,000 plus 8,000, total 41,000. Divide by how many records are there? How many employees are there? 5 are there. So 41,000 divided by 5, you get 8,200. So average of salary is what? 8,200. Clear, no? Let's take an example. Let's do it here. So first to display the table, select star from EMP table. So it displays the table. This is the employee table. Okay, we'll find the average of this salary. So how to find? Select by using AVG functions, AVG of in bracket salary from which table? From EMP table. Okay, select and run. So it finds what? Average. So average is how much? 8,200. So 41,000 divided by 5, you get 8,200. Clear, no? Next, second function, count function. Count function returns the number of rows present in the table, either based on some conditions or without condition. Count function what counts? How many employees are there? So here 5 employees are there. It counts how many employees are there. Okay, like this. So if you give some conditions, okay, example age equal to 22, how many employees are there? Only one employee. Okay, example, one more example, whose salary is 8,000. How many employees having 8,000? One and this one, 2 employees, like this. You can give condition like this. Okay, So count function count. The syntax is what? Select count of column name from table name. Select count of column name from table name. So consider the following example. So this is employee table. SQL query to count employees satisfying specified condition. See, for example, select count of name from EMP where salary is equal to 8000. You have to count the number of employees whose salary is 8000. Okay, how many employees having salary 8000? There are 2 employees. So the output is what? The result of the above query will be 2. Okay, let's do here. So first display the table. So this is the employee table. Now you write SQL query to count of employee from table name is EMP, condition is where. Okay, if you just simply want to find how many employees are there, just write select count of name from EMP, just select it, then click run. So how many employees are there? 5 employees are there. So it displays what? 5. Clear, no? Then if you give condition whose salary is 8000, how many employees having salary 8000, then you give condition where salary equal to 8000, where salary is equal to 8000. How many employees having salary 8000? 2 employees. So here it displays what? 2. So 2 employees having salary 8000. Clear, no? If we give 10,000, how many employees having salary 10,000? Only 1 employee. So it displays 1. Clear, no? Okay. So only 1 employee is having 10,000, so it displays 1. Next, example of count distinct. Count of distinct. Consider the same table. SQL query is select count of distinct salary from employee. Okay, you have to find what distinct salary, who is having unique salary, distinct salary from EMP. Okay, you have to count how many employees having distinct salary. Okay, how many employees having distinct salary? Okay, so 8000 repeated 2 times. Okay, so distinct, so how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 8000 is repeated. Okay, so total 4. Okay, distinct of salary, count of distinct of salary. From employee table. So it displays 4. Clear, no? Okay. So here 4 employees having distinct salary. So 8000 is repeated. Clear, no? This is about distinct. Next, max function. Max function returns a maximum value from selected column of the table. It finds what maximum value. Okay, example maximum salary like this. So syntax of max function is select max of column name from table name. Select max of column name from table name. Consider the following EMP table. SQL query to find maximum salary will be. Okay, for example, select max of salary. Max means what? Maximum salary from EMP. So which is the maximum salary here among these 5 employees? So 10,000 is maximum. So it displays what? 10,000. So here select max of salary from from EMP. Just select it, then click 1. What is the maximum salary here? Maximum salary is 10,000. So maximum salary is 10,000. So among these 5 employees, okay, maximum salary is 10,000. Next, min function. Min function returns minimum value from selected column of the table. Syntax of min function is select min of column name from table name. Consider the following table. SQL query to find the minimum salary will be, example, select min of salary from EMP table. Okay, min of salary, what is the minimum salary among these 5 employees? So 6,000 is the minimum. So definitely you will get minimum salary is 6,000. Okay, so here select min of salary from EMP. So what is the minimum salary? 6,000. 6,000 is the minimum salary. Clear, no? This is about the min function. Okay. Next, last one, sum function. Sum function returns total sum of a selected column numeric values. Okay. Total functions, what finds what? Total. It adds all the values. Example, salary. All the employees' salaries. Okay. It must be a numeric values. Okay. You can't add characters. Okay. Only numeric values you can add. Syntax of sum function is select sum of column name from table name. Select sum of column name from table name. Okay, for all the functions, for all the aggregate, only aggregate function, you have to replace what function name. Remaining all are same. The syntax of all the function is same. Only you have to change what? Okay, here sum, avg, count, max, min, sum, like this. Okay, remaining all are same. Very easy to remember. Consider the following table. This is the table. SQL query to find sum of salaries. To find the sum of salaries. Okay. What is the total? 17,000, 9,000 plus 8,000, 17,000 plus 6,000, 23,000, 33,000 plus 8, 41,000. Okay. Total is 41,000. It finds the total. Clear, no? Okay. Select sum of salary from EMP. Select and click on run button. It displays total salary is 41,000. Okay, clear, no? Total salary is 41,000. Clear, no? These are about aggregate functions. Clear, no? Okay. Thank you.